From Wall Street to Main Street, News 8's Project Economy is our commitment to coverage beyond the headlines. Work continues on the massive expansion project at Sugarloaf Ski Resort in Carrabassett Valley. Over the next 5 years, the mountain will construct hundreds of acres of glade skiing, which, according to Sugarloaf, will make it the largest ski resort in the East. News 8's Steve Minich joins us from the newsroom with a closer look at the project. Steve.
Well, Tracy, first of all, these aren't your typical ski trails that you can look up and see running down the front of the mountain. Glade skiing is actually skiing in the woods on natural, ungroomed snow. But as massive as this project is, it's delicate work, with the emphasis on protecting the very area the workers are cutting. If not for that constant buzz of chainsaws from deep in the woods, you might never know any work was even happening. You won't see big trucks or heavy equipment. On this job, it's strictly manpower.
Heavy equipment and skidders, they'll disrupt the earth and the ground, and that's exactly what we're trying to avoid.
It really is truly a win-win situation for the green movement and obviously getting us a lot more ski terrain.
Sugarloaf's general manager says eventually more than 600 acres of new terrain, offering the type of ski adventure that's quickly becoming a necessity to a ski resort's continued success.
You know, particularly the younger set has really gotten excited about getting off the groomed trails, if you will, and getting into the country a little bit more, the backcountry, as part of that whole wilderness experience.
How good of a representation is this for what we'll see ultimately?
Pretty good. You know, it'll vary depending on terrain.
But crew foreman Roddy Erlenbach says protecting that terrain's environment is every bit as important as carving out the perfect powder run. Home to several animal species, he says by selective cutting, leaving behind all the stumps and debris, and creating buffer zones around the nearby stream, the animals will not just survive, but thrive here.
We're going to end up creating more habitat for them, which is something that we're very proud to be able to brag about, that we're not just offering something new to the skiers, but also to the wildlife that lives up here.
The many trails and chairlifts running down Sugarloaf's face offer a stark contrast to the adjacent wilderness of Burnt Mountain, where the construction is ongoing. But the plan is, by cutting only the underbrush and not opening any large swaths, even when construction is finished, these undeveloped views won't change. In fact, you might never know any work had even happened.
A lot of people come to Sugarloaf not just to ski, but because of the pristine wilderness environment. So we want to be able to keep it that way as much as possible.
By the way, all of these plans had to be first approved by Maine's Department of Environmental Protection, as well as Inland Fisheries and Wildlife. And it's no wonder the project could take up to 5 years. At the current pace, crews are clearing just 1 to 2 acres a week. In the newsroom, Steve Minich, News 8.